Your turn. Coin, 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 coin.
Our families are going to come into contact with a lot of assessments throughout their child's education. So I love that the first times that they're coming into contact with assessments is 6 minutes of playing in a developmentally appropriate way of assessing children through their play.
What is he going to do next?
We use IGDIs to show parents that they are great parents, that they are doing things in the homes to help their child in the four components. In ECI, that's early communication indicators, their child is talking, their child is moving. It's all because of the great work that their that the parents is doing with their child. With socializations, the parent is socializing with their child every single day. With problem solving, so yes, we use this as a tool to show parents that, hey, you play with your child, and then you're taking what we're teaching you with the IGDIs and you're implementing it in the homes with your child.
So we visit our families once a week for 90 minutes year round. And we have a rotation of when we do our IGDIs. And so we typically do the same IGDI for all families on a schedule. I'll bring the toy out, and depending on what it is, like if it's the Epsi, I'll say, okay, let's remember that you can't show them how to do it and you can't tell them how to do it. You can just encourage them to play with the toy.
What is that?
But then with the ECI and the ESI, the socialization assessment, then it's like, okay, you want to be, you both want to be sitting on the floor. You need to be facing them to encourage the language. So I really try to explain it really well beforehand. So when we're actually scoring, when I'm actually scoring, it's the best that we can get at that time.
I do like that they're all playing with the same toy. So one round they're all doing the barn, one round they're all doing the house. And so that does make it a common factor. So when we're looking at their scores and if there are big differences, it's not because of the toy, it's because of where they are developmentally. They always want to know how their kids are doing. And this gives them a concrete tool to really see how they're doing compared to other children in the area.
They may hear from an expert that it's important to read your child, but they may not know exactly why. And when they get to experience assessments like this, they can explain to people in their lives, this is why I read to my child, or this is why we have a word wall at home, and this is why we do motor skill play, where we're not just having them run outside for no reason. We have a reason behind the way we're parenting.
It gives a objective look at a 6 minute observation of how the child did that day and where that child was doing well and where are some areas that we can continue to grow. So it really takes that that judgment out of it. It's just, this is where they were that day. And we can try it again another day. So it really helps have a conversation with families that's very objective and can really focus on strengths and areas of growth.
One of the things that I love about IGDIs is the graphs, because it provides parents a visual of where their child is in per IGDI.
And it's really a starting point, is how we pose it to the parents, is this is what we want to look at and see what you notice, and let's talk about, is this what you see at home as well? How do you feel about this data?
You can see where one child is at, but you can also really look at where the classroom is at and then make changes to the different activities in the day, the different materials throughout the day, to really work on addressing some of the things that they see as trends for the classroom.
It's nice to see all of their points on one chart to show where they've improved and where they're growing. So it's been a very interesting and very useful tool so far.
Another way we've used this data is for research. When we used strategies consistently, we saw children's growth on the ECI go up consistently. And so we saw a lot of really great progress with this.
If the child is in the gray area, you can split up the graph into four different graphs showing gestures, vocalization, single words, multiple words on all the graphs, no matter what IGDI it is. And so then we can delve deeper into, okay, where were they lacking exactly compared to their peers, and really break down the data.
When you see children who are not developing as expected, you know, it really does give us a way of communicating with families about how their child is doing. Our parents often have had other children, and if that child is developing like their other child, you know, they might see that as normal. But this is a way for us to show, you know, this is where your child is at. This is where other children your child's age are at. At that time, we can start talking about, you know, are there other things that we can be doing with your child, that you can be doing with your child, or is it that we need some extra services for your child?
So this is a great tool for them to have and hold and say, I can tell that they're doing well because I have the data here. They've done the assessment at school. Mm-hmm. And also, child-led play is a great way to build the connection, and that's what they do with IGDIs.
You wanna play? We're gonna stack them up.